Okay, so I got asked the question on from an advanced student who's getting into states of bliss and found awakening to leave. That's the context to that they're now got the thing to leave the Course in Miracles. It doesn't resonate any longer, and it does say a few things on that. Of course, everything is. I mean, the Course in Miracles, for me, is. I like the lessons more than the text. You know, the practical application, but it is for people in a significant amount of duality, to work on lessons who still feel they are a body, and they are their thoughts, and they are still significantly plagued by identification with this world. So it is adjusted at a level of significant duality to try and take through the applying the course lessons to dissolving the ego. And at the end of the Course in Miracles, it says that you can now throw away the book because there's no point in, you know, you're beyond what the, I mean, the course has got you to the infinite. So there isn't a resonance to do the lessons any longer. To get to the infinite, because one is there already. Also, there are more advanced states of the infinite than what the course, you know, to than what the course is alluding to, because it's pitched at a certain type of student for where they are in their journey. So one will outgrow it at a certain point, and it will no longer resonate. It's no longer needed. Also, for certain students, I'm sure we say use the word students loosely. As you get into these more infinite, sublime states, it's more, it's less about reading stuff and applying stuff, and it's more about going deeper into that experience. Actually, it's not actually useful to try and re-identify with form. And try and go back into those lower levels of consciousness of identifying with words and trying to apply things which are not resonating any longer. So at certain states, I mean, like with my teacher, Dr. David R Hawkins, at a certain point he went into such sublime states of, shall we say, ecstasy and bliss that, you know, he left his wife, he left his job, and just went off into the desert for some years. To go more intensely into those states. And also there's an adjustment process of being in those very, very high consciousness states, which does require a certain level of solitude and going deeper within. That's directed by the infinite. So that's also at very advanced states. You know, there can be huge rearrangements, and also can occur the need not to engage in the world as before, and that can be a journey. You know, it's just led by the infinite source. So that's up. You know, for an advanced student who's now, it's not resonating. I would say that's probably appropriate not to. You know, the course is not required at that level. It's really what's being called is to go deeper. And sometimes it can be to stop interacting with the world as well. There's no longer that need to ident you know, to interact. There's more of a calling to go deeper into the state, or one is led there. So that can also occur. There's different stages of spiritual. You know, you can't really use words, but as you lose identification with the world. To go deeper into those infinite states, so that can also be a part of the journey, and that is the right thing to do, as one is led inwardly at advanced levels. Of course, you know that it's different to be, you know, students who are at the beginning very dualistic, that think they're the body and the thoughts. In which case, I would say the Course in Miracles has a lot of utility for that stage in a student's journey. So yeah, I mean, I think for me, listening to a Hawkins journey, and you know, it is there are very, very distinct states. You know, his journey was similar to mine, addiction, very much in the body, ego, and thinking, then suddenly getting very, very profound experiences and actually going through the death of the ego as well, which is enlightenment. Anyway, I'll stop there.